Hello. Zinvicta with a one round lead. I'm genuinely not salty about it.
Good. You shouldn't
but
be.
There was some funky stuff going on with the last
That last episode was a little bit of an anomaly. Especially with the bug that we had on round four, I think it was.
Yeah. It could have just have easily have gone my way. And, you know, that's why I'm not salty, but...
But it's not like there's not a historical, like, precedent that we've set. I mean, we ended season one literally tied.
True.
28-28. So, unless if one of us was just blowing the other one out of the water, losing because of one guess is going to be a hard thing to really get upset about.
True.
I almost said a boot for some reason.
I know. Maybe that's a foreshadowing of what we're going to get here.
I hope not. 3-2-1.
3-2-1. Good luck. Have fun.
Good luck. Have fun. Northern Lion.
Have fun. Well, certainly it was not foreshadowing.
Yeah. If this is Canada, then my name is Fred.
This could be like Saskatchewan, but that would be... The only reason I would ever suggest that is if literally it was Canada only. I'd be like, we must be in Saskatchewan.
We've had a couple of Canadian guesses that I would have never, ever thought I was looking at Canada. And Saskatchewan, definitely. But there's parts of Alberta that are, like, pretty, like, rural.
Oh, dude.
I hate saying that word.
There's parts of every province that are rural.
You cannot make a cool-looking face saying the word rural. It's such a weird pronunciation for a weird, like... looking word.
Dude, rural is actually probably like the final boss of learning English as a second language.
Yeah. I knew a kid in Bermuda, his name was Rory.
Okay, yeah.
And that name was very difficult to pronounce, although it was a very easy one to spell.
Dude, no kidding. R-U-R-I, Rory.
Yeah. I could be making a very culturally insensitive joke right now that was directed towards half of my heritage, and I'm not going to, but you could probably suss it out there.
I mean, it's true, you know, we dealt with it in Korea when we were teaching all the time. Korean makes, and Japanese as well. I can't speak for Chinese, but...
Definitely Chinese.
It makes no distinction between the character that we think is L and the character that we think is R.
Yep.
So, you know, and we as native English speakers are like, it's so obvious, but... You know, they just don't have the distinction. So they hear it as the same. Same with like V and P.
Yep.
Like in Korean, Vietnam is like Vietnam.
One thing I know about Japanese in particular is that they never, unless if it ends, I believe either it ends or if it begins with the letter that we know as I. I mean, Japanese knows what the letter I is. They don't actually enunciate it. So like a CHI would be just pronounced as just a CH. You wouldn't have the I, because the I sound is named or is made naturally by just saying the consonants that precede it.
I guess you almost have to have an implied vowel there to say it.
Right. But like even the word like Yoshi, like they don't pronounce Yoshi, it's Yosh. And then the I sound comes out naturally from making the SH. The only reason why I know this is not because I'm a weeb, but because...
Anime, yeah.
No, it's not because I'm a weeb. It's because
Japanese cartoons.
I was a roommate with someone who actually took...
Drew for Naruto.
Japanese lessons.
Okay.
And then he and his wife actually moved to Japan for like 5 years, which is awesome.
You can turn it back around, like... Because it might seem to some people like we're... punching down. The number of times in Korea that I'd be like, you know, oh, I'm going to Seoul. And the Korean person would be like, it's not Seoul. It's Seoul. And I'd be like, Seoul. And they're like, no, 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 it's not Seoul. It's Seoul. And I'm like, Seoul. And then I just repeat it like 10 times and eventually they're like, all right, either you got it or you're never going to get it, so I'm just going to tell you got it.
Just say Professor Ryan Dungabunga.
Yeah, basically. They have like an E-O sound that we think is O, but to Korean speakers, it's like an that we can't really pronounce.
Dude, this guess, I'm zoning out. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, no, this is actually horrible.
I'm just going right there. I don't even care. Sure, whatever. I'll take it. That's still getting a one.
I got 2 points.
What?
I guessed Australia.
What is wrong with Northern Lion?
What is wrong with me? What are you talking about? How could I saw no information.
You...
I'm not going to say anything.
What did you... We must have gone in two different directions, or I, like, blacked out, because I saw nothing.
I guess. Nothing about that said Australia to me.
Really? Like, the sparsely populated wilderness?
But, yeah, but, I mean, like, the type of grass and stuff that we see was
the
farmland.
Type of... Oh, is this where we're at now?
No, it was, like, farmland, dude. You can't get mad at me.
No, like I said, on farm in Australia, they import all the food they eat.
You can't get mad at me for your terrible guess.
I'm just mad at your reasoning. That makes no sense that there was farmland.
There was plenty of trucks, and there was plenty of things that said, this is not Australia. Mainly, the color of the freaking ground and the dirt wasn't red.
Okay, I'll give you that.
And the like the arid part looks like it would be a little bit cooler temperatures than anything you'd see in Australia. Like the type of grass.
I don't think you can infer the temperature from the picture that was taken, but
agree to disagree, because I clearly did. I didn't have one inclination that was Australia.
Correlation doesn't equal causation. I actually think that we got the bug again, and that was Australia.
What?
But They gave us pictures of Australia, but put us in America. They got the bug.
I think you might. I'm going to have to watch your point of view, because nothing about that said Australia to me.
So, like, I mean, do you know where we are in this one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I always have a rough time between three countries that are very close to each other over here. It's got to be this country. See, then I see this down here, and I'm like, this is my exact phrase, this is the exact word that I'm saying right now. Two words merged into one city name.
Is it Krong Batambong?
Yep.
It is a little insensitive, but you probably could remake the Thong Song with just Cambodian city names.
You can send a place
to Krong Kimpong Chomp, like
send a place to northernlion@gmail.com or whatever your email is.
I'm just, you know,
the Krong to Chong.
That's the name of the city. At least that's the way we're pronouncing it.
We'll probably stop this line of.
Yeah, anyway. It's been an incendiary episode so far.
Especially after that last episode.
Yeah, in which I suggested that. The one amongst us who is actually Chinese might do better on a Chinese guess, like some kind of jerk.
Yeah, if I said, we're in Canada, definitely Ryan Letourneau would be
Canada
able to get it.
Canada does give people... me an advantage, but we also both speak English, so like it doesn't give me that much of an advantage. When I see Chinese... I don't always know it's Chinese. I have to go through, like, the first step of being like, maybe this is actually Japanese.
People get mad at me for complaining about Canada guesses a lot.
They should.
But there's, like, I understand that we have probably had way more North American guesses than Canadian guesses.
Pardon me?
Oh, you think that's an understatement?
No, dude, Canada's part of North America.
I mean, sorry, okay, United States. The Northern 48.
No, I agree with you 100% on that. Like, that, and that's why you shouldn't complain.
Is that durian?
It could be worse.
That doesn't look like... Oh, you already made your guess?
Yeah, but I mean, it's like...
All right, well, I'll make
I could have made my guess 4 minutes ago.
You got me by 500.
It's a star, dude. I gotta make up 4,000, so...
You got a long way to go over that.
It's true.
This could be a legendary comeback if you end up pulling this one off, even the series again.
That's the only reason. I wouldn't say I get mad, but when you complain about Canadian guesses, I'm like, we get America probably, like, four times as much as we get Canada.
It's not our... Well, I guess technically it could be considered RNG bias, but... Yeah.
I think they've just gotten more of America mapped.
What just happened here?
Tends to show up more frequently. Oh my lord.
We go from we're on the surface of Mars to everything's nice and green and peachy, and then it goes back to Mars again.
Yeah, this is Mars.
Why is it so red?
It's Egypt.
What kind of plant is that?
You can see the pyramid over there.
Yeah, I was also making that connection as well. No, it's not. That's the camera. It's the camera that's doing it. It's making that reddish tint.
Because
if you look to the right or left, the shrubbery is not exact. It's not red. This looks like something straight out of like World of Warcraft. I'm gonna say War of the Worlds. Tom Cruise adaptation.
Yeah, like after the tripods comb the landscape.
Yeah, and they start like using us as fertilizer.
Yeah.
Excuse me, sign. You're supposed to have something on it. Yeah, there we go.
Does it say potholes?
It begins with a P.
Does it say potholes?
No.
What?
The green sign that says a city that I've. I cannot glean any information from.
Is it Pittsburgh?
It begins with a P.
Is it Philadelphia?
I'm gonna stop answering.
Fourth largest metropolitan area in the United States.
I'm gonna stop answering this question.
Fifth largest, sorry, my mistake. Okay.
I don't think that we're in the country I thought we were in. Like, this doesn't really seem like a... by the way, I'm not suggesting that this country doesn't have power, but I'm just saying. Those are some old-timey looking power lines. But the name of this, the name of the town that I've seen is not synonymous with the country that I thought, which was originally this country.
I am extremely lucky and have found where we are.
What?
Yep. We're going like...
We've got to be like...
This way.
Got to be over here, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I got 49.94.
What?
Essentially...
I haven't made my guess, by the way.
I just zoomed in. Yeah, I'm not going to give up too much. It's one of those like perfect situations where you're like, oh, I'm going to spend 20 minutes looking for this. And then you just zoom in and the number is right in front of you.
We're from. I've only seen a city with a... I don't even know if I'm in the right country right now. I think I am. It's the only one that makes sense with all of this plus part of that name plus this. Oh, this is terrible.
Sounds like you're on the right track.
$9.94.
I found it, is all I can say.
I was fine.
I was looking, and I found it.
I have no idea. More center. I'll leave it there. Ooh, okay. Oh, there it is. There's Petrusville right there.
Yeah.
What sign did you see that you... Oh, you must have found the road marker.
It said Petrusville and Phillipstown and then Kolborg or something.
Yeah, I only got one Petrusville and it was 10 kilometers away. But I couldn't... Obviously, I didn't find it on the map. I got 47.15.
God damn it.
I was really, really close... I was really close to thinking that that was Mexico, or at least the far...
That would have been friggin' sweet.
Oh, yeah, for you.
Yeah.
But then I saw, like...
You can tell from the temperature of the...
Of this
the
guy getting
film
mad.
Lens.
That it's not my fault that you guessed Australia on round one.
Well, you could see the nitrogen-fixing plants here, so...
Freaking guy. This looks like a place that you don't want to be without any sort of bug spray. Like, there's going to be a lot of mosquitoes on here. Dude, I
feel like we must be, like, here.
We've got to be close to somewhere around here. You guess her.
Like, here's my impression right now. I think we're in a tropical region
Yep.
that practices Islam.
That sounds right.
That could
practices
be.
Practices Islam.
Could be here. Yeah, you don't think so?
Getting Islam.
This might actually be ignorant, but I thought I saw a city name that started with all, like A-L dash.
Oh, man.
This Wait, might, that's not...
The last two episodes of GeoGuessers, branching into this one, let's count how many people somehow get offended
that's
by something.
That's not offensive. It's a geographic clue.
Okay.
It's like if you saw... you know, an Asian person and being like, I think we're in Asia right here. Wow. I know that there are not all places like Alabama.
Was it going to be Asian?
Alabama is obviously not like predominantly Arabic, but I'm just saying.
I think we're somewhere like over here.
You got to use the clues you're given, dude.
Closer are we to the water? What I want to know.
Also, I see people wearing, like, ceremonial headgear.
Yeah?
I'm just saying I refuse to take the L for my assumption. Because I think it's founded in reality.
Alright. Dude, I don't know what brand this color, like, represents, but they've got it locked down over here. They have bought... Well, that says a...
Dude,
does that say Apache?
Wow. I've got a great idea for a business.
Okay.
Simbicta. Wherever we are, let's go open up a motorcycle dealership here.
Yeah. And a helmet dealership.
Demand is through the roof.
You're not going to find too many cars on this road. Oh, I see. I see the headdressing you're talking about. What's this place selling? Bananas. Those don't look like they're kept at a nominal temperature. What is contained in is this gas? They've got this huge funnel and these plastic containers filled with some sort of liquid. Gonna make my guess. Yeah, okay.
God damn it.
I think it's like a 3, I guess.
I agree.
All right, well.
Oh, round 5 already, huh?
Yeah, I'm at 16-16.
Literally uncatchable.
All right, what I like to hear.
Thanks a lot, Australia.
You can't get mad at Australia.
I can get mad at Australia for every part in Australia. It looks like it's the middle of the shot taken from the freaking moon.
GeoGuessers is so fun. It's a great concept for a game.
It really is. It's a fun game.
And it's free. Unless you pay for GeoGuessr Pro like myself and Northern Lion do, and then you pay $2.50 a month or something.
Aren't we like... It must be like down here.
Country spells highway with H-I-W-A-Y.
Or are we... Maybe this is...
Highway stabilizers. I understand the first part, or the second part. The first, that's not how you spell highway. Let's see what this sign says. Extreme care. Single lane road with passing bays. 35.
35 what? I'm going to go ahead and guess kilometers.
Yeah. Per hour.
I think we might not be in America.
You would be correct on that assumption. This is a very odd collection of different types of trees. Because if you didn't know any better, you'd say that we were somewhere tropical. But then everything, like, once it branches out, it's like, oh, we're actually, like, in, like, New Zealand. And I don't believe that we're in New Zealand. I guess we could be in New Zealand.
I don't know, to be honest.
No dumping rubbish. We are not in America.
Yeah. get your trash out of here.
Yeah.
That's what they'd say.
They'd say take it to the refuse bin.
You know,
No, this can't be New Zealand. I wonder if this is one of those oddball Tasmania guesses.
It does happen.
And they always, like, destroy us. Or at least destroys me. What happened to this sign? Are these spider eggs? Dude, are you seeing... What direction are you going?
It's doubtful.
I'm going northwest-ish.
Yeah, I'm going, like, just exactly west.
If you happen to come across a caution road narrows ahead sign, look at it. It either looks like it's been shot with a bunch of BBs or pellets, or that's a bunch of spider eggs on it. Either way, I have many questions about the origins of the sign.
I hope it's not spider eggs.
I mean, if we're in this part of the world, it may very well be. That's not an ignorant statement.
You know what? I hope it is spider eggs. Because the spiders will eat all the worst insects, right?
Yeah, spiders are actually one of the most human-friendly insects in the world. Sorry, arachnids in the world. They help out humans way more than mosquitoes do, I'll tell you that.
Did you know spiders are not insects?
They're arachnids.
Correct.
Yes, I corrected
myself.
Like,
arachnids are not a subclass of insects.
I realize that. That's why I corrected myself.
I'm just saying a lot of people think that spiders are insects.
They're not. They're arachnids.
They're not insects. It's correct.
They don't have an exoskeleton.
Who's got the bio degree now?
You do. Mr. Chimpanzees aren't apes.
Well, that's just more of like a for conversations.
Ah, I didn't guess.
Well,
I got too wrapped up in the spiders.
It was New Zealand, but I don't want to talk about it.
It was New Zealand.
Yeah.
I was actually right about that for once.
Well, Sid Victor, you've opened up quite the lead.
It was a two-game lead.
Two-game lead.
That's nothing to really brag about.
For now, though, thanks for watching. I hope you guys have enjoyed the episode. If you did, click the like button. Upside a great deal. Of course, subscribe if you want to see more in the future. But for now, thanks for watching. We'll see you next time with a guest, probably.
Hopefully, maybe. Thanks for watching, everyone.
Later.